extend my warm welcome to Dr. Manjana
Azan, President, Institute Innovation Council, TMU, Dr. Gitanshu, Convener, TMU IIC, Dr. Vipin Jain, Principal, TMIMT TMU. It's my proud privilege to introduce our guest speaker, Dr. Isha Jain, for today's session on Accelerator Incubation Opportunities for Students and Faculties, Early Stage Entrepreneurs. Dr. Isha Jain is a faculty in the Finance, Accounting and Entrepreneurship area with more than 14 years of work experience with PhD and UGC NET qualification. Currently, she is associated with the School of Management and Liberal Studies and appointed as a president of Institution Innovation Council of the North Cap University, Gurugram, an awardee of Eminent Educationist Award, Asia Pacific Gold Star Award, Young Women Educator and Scholar Award, and Excellence Award 2017. She was also selected for Rajiv Gandhi Education Excellence Award and Bharat Vidya Shiromani Award. She is the resource person for various faculty development programs, workshop, conference, seminar, webinars at national and international levels. She is also awarded 29 honors and awards, including 17 Best Research Papers Awards and a Dean Committee Choice Award in various international conferences of repute. She has been invited by IIM Indore for review of institutional development plans under the World Bank supported Madhya Pradesh Higher Education Quality Improvement Projects to be submitted to the Department of Higher Educational Government of Madhya Pradesh. She took training modules of Chartered Institutions Management Accounts, London, UK, and is certified by the Institute of Chartered Accounts of India for conducting investor awareness programs in institutions and organizations. She has published 7 patents with the Government of India and 2 patents with the Government of Australia. More than 90 of her research papers are published in various international journals, including Scopus and Web of Sciences. And conference proceedings of repute, as well as she authored 2 books. One is on foreign exchange management, and another one is on principles of management with text and cases under repute brands. She has also presented more than 80 research papers and cases at various national and international conferences, as well as has chaired various national and international seminars and conferences. She as a chairperson, keynote speaker, and panelist. She has also associated with 12 various international journals as editorial board member, academic advisor, research paper reviewer, and editor-in-chief. She's also an external examiner for evaluating PhD thesis for Jain University, Bangalore, University of Madras, and the University of Pune. A certified technical analyst from the Government of NCT of Delhi and Government of India, an Amazon trained e-commerce specialist. She has also qualified a module of financial market with distinction organized by National Stock Exchange of India. Now I request Isha ma'am to please start the session. Thank you.
Good morning to all of you. Thank you so much, Prachi ma'am, for your kind invitation as well as for a nice introduction to this session. I'm very thankful to be the part of the Tirthankar Mahavir University for this session organized under the Institution Innovation Council of TMU. So today we will discuss about the incubators opportunities for early stage entrepreneurs. So for that, let me share my PPT with all of you. Okay, so when we're talking about the incubation opportunities for students and faculties early stage entrepreneurs, so here, you know, startups have emerged as a key driver of economic growth and job creation and are often a catalyst for radical innovation. Now, during the COVID-19 crisis, startups have continued to play a critical role for economies. Some innovative young firms have reacted fast and flexibly to the pandemic and have been critical in helping many countries shift towards fully digital work, education, and health services, and have provided innovations in medical goods and services. Now the crisis is reducing the creation of startups, challenging their survival, and limiting their growth. So a missing generation of new firms has significant implications for economic outcomes, notably employment, then giving startups disproportionate contribution to job creation, which can be mitigated by supporting existing startups and the creation of new firms. Policymakers should tackle short-term challenges, but also, and importantly, foster the ability of startups to grasp new business opportunities, reducing barriers to entrepreneurship, providing the right incentives, and boosting entrepreneurial potentials. Now, when we're talking about the challenges faced by startups due to COVID-19, now most existing startups face significant challenges due to COVID-19 crisis, as they are more vulnerable than older incumbents to the shock brought by the pandemic. They tend to engage in high-risk activities compared with other small and medium-sized firms, face constraints in accessing traditional funding, and have a formative relationship at best with suppliers and customers. They also often crucially rely on a small founding team, and this can further increase their vulnerability to labor supply shocks during the pandemics. Now, at a time marked by significant economic uncertainty, and with their revenues affected by containment measures and significant drop in demand, startups become even more financially fragile and need support for their short-term liquidity needs critical for their survival. Now, in many of the countries, policy responses aimed at shielding the economy from the crisis are already targeting firms' financial fragilities, especially for SMEs. Now, these include measures to sustain short-term liquidity needs, such as loan guarantees, direct lending, grants, subsidies, and so on. So, some countries have introduced measures more specifically focused on startups. For example, France has set up a 4 billion euros fund to support startup liquidity, including bridging startup funding rounds. Germany has announced a tailored startup aid program, expanding and facilitating venture capital financing. And the UK has announced a co-financing fund for innovative companies facing financial difficulties. Now, COVID-19 is not only a challenge for existing startups, but also for the creation of new ones. So periods of crisis usually correspond to drops in business regulations. So the analysis shown here confirms that the firm creation dropped significantly across many countries in March and April 2020, with a decline as such as 70% in April 2020 in Portugal compared to the same month of prior year, and 46%, 54%, and 58% in Hungary, France, and Turkey respectively. Milder but still very strong declines are evident in Australia, US, and Spain as well. Now, micro, small, and medium enterprises, which have created more than 90% of the jobs in India, employing over 140 million people and contributing 30% of the GDP, are at the risk of having a severe cash crunch if the lockdown again extended to more weeks. So many of these MSMEs have loan obligations and monthly EMIs to pay, and many of them might just disappear if their cash cycle is disturbed because of the lockdown, with fixed assets dangling over them in such a situation. Now they need a moratorium for loan repayments, and RBI has released funds to non-banking financial corporations, some of whom provide finance to MSMEs. In addition to that, movement of perishable goods is hampered, so these businesses start at huge losses. India cannot have a real and sustainable growth without having a thriving MSME sector. The COVID-19 crisis will also test the resilience of startups in India, and startups have to rely on cross-border fundraising. Several founders are seeing their businesses grinding to a halt, receivables are spiraling, and they have to undertake painful cost reduction measures in their ventures. Government will have to make funds available to this sector, as venture capital firms may take a little longer to come and support because of the restricted global capital flows. International and internal mobility is restricted, and the revenues generated by travel and tourism, which contributes 9.2% of GDP, will take a major toll in the GDP growth rate. Aviation revenues come down by $1.56 billion. Oil has plummeted to 18-year low. of $22 per barrel in March, and foreign portfolio investors have withdrawn huge amounts from India, about $571.4 million. While lower oil prices will shrink the current account deficit, reverse capital flows will expand it. Rupee is continuously depreciating. MSME will undergo a severe cash crunch. The crisis witnessed a horrifying mass exodus of such floating population of migrants on foot amidst countrywide lockdown. So their worries primarily were loss of job, daily ration, and absence of a social security net. Now, according to Nasdaq, China is the world's largest economy when compared to other countries in terms of purchasing power parity. And before the outbreak of the virus in China, which turned into a pandemic, country had a GDP of $27.31 trillion. When it comes to the Indian startup ecosystem, the inflow of funds and supplies from China has been a key source of strength for new age ventures. In fact, leading Chinese investors had called India their most important market at Thai Global Summit 2019. And it was also the year when Chinese companies had invested $3.9 billion in Indian startups. Although China is already on a path to recovery, it is unlikely that investors from China and other Southeast Asian countries will be eager to pump funds in the pandemic hit market landscape. This can translate into a tangible blow to the funding machinery for enabling budding and growth stage startups in India. While most startups in their growth stage may have already completed their first or seed round of funding, they will find it difficult to move on to the next rounds of capital infusion in the present scenario. And so how will they keep their business running, let alone expand and scale? So this is another point of worry plaguing the country's startup community, and the lockdown, if prolonged, might lead to funding timelines to be pushed even further, leading to a cash crunch in most companies that were looking to raise funds. The past couple of months have seen sales dropping for many industries. Even if the deal has already been made with the investor, it might be delayed or put on hold indefinitely or until the lockdown lifts. So moreover, raising fresh funding will take a backseat for many a venture in the current scheme of things. Now, while the pandemic has affected all businesses, some sectors have taken a greater hit as compared to others in India. Travel and hospitality, aviation and retail seem to have majorly borne the brunt of the situation. As of March 6, approximately 585 international flights were cancelled by private airlines. Even domestic travel, including buses and trains, has been halted. Restaurants and malls have been closed. With these startups in the travel and hospitality sector would be finding it extremely difficult to even keep their businesses running, since there is no cash inflow from both customers as well as investors. Even Indian stock market vulnerable to the rise in COVID cases, with you can see in the present scenario with their volatility and fluctuations in the markets. Now, while startups in most sectors have seen a slump in business, there are some for whom the pandemic has brought serendipitous opportunities. For example, in sync with the surge in the demand for medical equipment and supplies, the healthcare and biotech sectors have seen re-energized activity over the last 3 months. With the country being placed under lockdown, sectors such as edtech, entertainment, OTT platforms like Hotstar, Netflix, Amazon Prime have also experienced a significant expansion of their consumer base. Although governments across the world are endeavoring to contain the spread of the virus, it will take a few months at least before the global situation regains its erstwhile equilibrium. And on the other hand, the global market is also expected to undergo major paradigm shifts once the pandemic blows over. Now, all startups would be wise to do two fundamental things. First, in the absence of certainty on revenues, they must preserve cash at all costs so that they can survive this phase and be ready to get going as soon as the curtain lifts. Secondly, they must be ready to go back to the drawing board to recraft their business models and maybe even the sectors they are in. One startup, for instance, has shifted gears in a matter of weeks and is getting ready to manufacture ventilators for hospitals to deal with COVID-19. The transformation will be driven by new awareness of the criticality of sectors such as healthcare and logistics that are currently sustaining our society under quarantine. So the post-coronavirus world will witness the rise of new market segments and newer opportunities that innovators can seize to not only make the world whole again, but also drive it towards a healthier future. So India must rethink on her development paradigm and make it more inclusive, COVID-19 has also provided some unique opportunities to India, and there is an opportunity to participate in global supply chains, multinationals, and they are losing trust in China. To make in India, some reforms are needed, labor reforms being one of them. Now, what are the various opportunities for startups in times of crisis? Notwithstanding the significant economic disruption caused by the COVID-19 crisis, long-term effects on employment and innovation may be mitigated by taking steps now to support existing startups and creation of new firms. In fact, even as the number of new business registrations generally drops during recessions, many successful innovative startups or businesses have emerged from periods of crisis. Examples include Dropbox, Uber, Airbnb, WhatsApp, Groupon, Pinterest, which were all founded during or just after the global financial crisis, and Alibaba's Taobao that was founded during the SARS outbreak in China in 2002. So this confirms that periods of crisis are not only a challenge, but also provide new opportunities for entrepreneurs, as startups can help address the constraints created by difficult health or economic conditions and respond to changing preferences and needs. Now, relevant examples in the time of COVID-19 are like, first, there are opportunities for startups that introduce radical innovations that can be useful in the short run. Today, that could mean innovations in telemedicine, remote personal care, medical equipment, home delivery, food processing, teleworking, online education, contact tracing, and so on. Support for startups to respond to such short-term needs has been provided through targeted policy interventions, including a call from the European Commission for startups with technologies related to treating, testing, monitoring, or other aspects of COVID-19 outbreak to apply fast-track funding under the EIC accelerator program. Now, these, however, tend to ultimately address specific activities for which there is immediate demand or need. Second, and importantly, COVID-19 outbreak may induce persistent changes in societies, consumer habits, or needs that could uncover valuable business opportunities and for startups that are able to anticipate these changes. For example, demand for remote working, e-commerce, education, and health services may also change in the medium run, global value chains and cities may be transformed. So as we prepare to go back to a world which will be changed forever, the time is right to reset everything as we knew it. And if ever there was a lit time where it is a level playing field for both celebrated startups and the more modest ones, it's now. Startups that understand the new definition of normal will try to bring out the best in themselves by grabbing new opportunities and identifying new customers. So here are three ways to even start a new startup business idea with the recession around. There are opportunities to recover from a recession, particularly that which has become so unforeseen and dramatic because it brings up new issues that need to be addressed. Now, you think about your plan for selling it when you have your small business idea, and there are three options. The first one is the defining a goal. Now, getting a clear goal or why it is a smart idea. Whether there is a recession, it can build a distinction, competitive advantage, and loyalty to brands. Then make it affordable. If there's anything that people do not need right now, is overtly expensive products. So make sure you offer excellent quality at an affordable rate that you are planning with your new startup business idea. Then make it robust. People know when they buy cheap. They believe it twice, so that recessions can often lead to spending a little more on high quality goods, particularly if this needs to last for a long time and you can use it more frequently, such as garden furniture, cooking equipment, or home furniture. Now, small business opportunities that thrive irrespective of the corona impact. So here we will discuss number of business opportunities which, you know, early stage entrepreneurs, whether it can be faculty or students or anyone else, may enter during the time. So the first one here is the cleaning services. So as the COVID-19 cases throughout the world continue to climb a new height every day, so is the demand for janitorial services. Especially in the urban areas, a number of cleaning companies have witnessed an increase in number of cleaning and disinfection service requests. In the light of the pandemic, homeowners, apartment complexes, commercial high-rise buildings, and corporate offices are being reminded to continually clean and disinfect all commonly used areas to contain the virus from spreading. If you like to clean and you want to start a business with a little overhead, this is the business for you. All you need is proper planning, dedication, a little geographical marketing to get your business noticed. Second is delivery services. While many people are afraid to leave their homes or follow the local government's advice to stay inside the house, now senior citizens and immunocompromised individuals are on high alert, all with a single purpose, to keep themselves safe. That naturally has boosted on-demand delivery services. According to Business Wire, online food delivery will be the largest beneficiary with more than $104 billion market by 2023 among most other delivery services. So getting involved into a fast-growing delivery business can keep you profitably busy as long as you want. You can choose to create your own independent delivery service business or courier service to make the best out of a pandemic. With many delivery services implemented during the lockdown period, some of them would continue to serve long, even the pandemic is over, and many startups will come out with niche delivering that never used to be delivered. The next opportunity for early stage entrepreneurs can be remote fitness. Now the fitness sector was one among the many that faced a big jolt due to the lockdown worldwide, and the fitness industry is adjusting to a new reality by offering remote fitness services. Now you can grab this opportunity by providing on-demand virtual fitness classes that are gaining popularity. The pandemic has compelled people to maintain a healthy lifestyle and boost immunity. Given that fitness will play an integral role in boosting their immune system, there will be an opportunity for you, and however, choose the right niche based on the region, locality, and your expertise. Another opportunity, incubator opportunity for early stage entrepreneurs can be the cybersecurity consultant. Back in September of 2020, a major hospital chain in the US across 400 locations nationwide got hacked. It was presumably the largest cyber attack in US history. Predictably, these organizations, including big corporations, are going to invest billions of dollars to secure their server. But the wave is something different this time. The hackers will eye on the soft target, and they are likely to attack small and medium-sized businesses. Besides considering coronavirus, remote working or work from home has become a backbone for corporate culture these days, and many companies have already announced lifetime remote working for their employees. It is a good initiative, but many have experienced complexities as well. The transition from in-office to at-home operations, especially from the technology front. Now, cybersecurity has been a major concern for them, and they need a robust and permanent solution in place. If you have networking knowledge and IT expertise, you can start offering IT consulting services to companies recommending programs and tools for keeping business data secure. Meanwhile, cybersecurity maintenance and training staff will also be in high demand. Another incubator opportunity for early stage entrepreneurs can be e-commerce. Now, pandemic has been a major blow to physical retail stores worldwide that compelled many retailers to explore a robust alternate option like e-commerce platform. And 2021, this year, accelerate e-commerce to even higher levels that alternatively allow many business aspirants to start a business online and offline. Now this is evident because US and Canadian e-commerce orders reported 129% year over year growth last year by April 2020, and while 146% overall online retail orders. Another opportunity can be the party committee or the cleanup committee. After a night long party and drinking, people are too exhausted.
Ma'am, please unmute yourself.
Okay, so ma'am, when it got muted?
Just now. Actually, I was muting a student.
Okay. So you can start this business if you are exploring business options with a little overhead. It is an all-season business and can keep you profitably busy. And most importantly, this business doesn't require intense promotions, as you can easily promote your services by distributing your visiting card among the individuals, corporate offices, societies, and so on. So from the skill front, you only require experience in cooking and cleaning. Another opportunity can be online reseller. Now, if you have an excellent eye for fashion, passion for clothing, and incredible sales technique, then starting an online reseller business could be your call. Initially, you can start it is as a side hustle and gradually turn it into a full-time resale business. Even though success in this business requires time and dedication, and it is easy to start and achieve success. Websites like Poshmark and Mercury offer the best options to those individuals looking to sell their unwanted clothing. So if capable, you can develop your own resale website as well. Another opportunity can be freelance copywriter. If you are passionate about writing, you can make your passion a convertible business. All you need is a bit of marketing knowledge. Whether you want to write blogs, web content, social media content, press release, or write resumes, there are plenty of companies out there to pay you for your services. Freelance writers and copywriters have been in high demand since work from home was implemented amid coronavirus crisis. And if you have a little SEO knowledge, you can increase charges for your writing SEO-friendly copy. The average charge you will receive for a copywriting job, if I'm talking in dollars, then it can be $40 to $50 per hour. While based on the experience and given what it is, you can increase the charges even further. So freelance copywriting is a great business to run because as long as you have an internet connection, you can work. And most importantly, you can operate from the comfort of your own home or even from the road if you travel. If you establish a large enough network and gain referrals from satisfied clients, you could even make freelance writing your full-time job as well. Another opportunity can be home care services. Now, if you love serving people, or if you are a professional caregiver, providing home care service can be the most profitable business for you. According to data from National Institute on Aging, the 85 plus population will increase 351% from 2010 to 2050, while those over age 100 will increase tenfold in number. So almost all these populations will need care mostly in their homes. Experience or background in healthcare is not mandatory in this, but those skills could be in demand. Many seniors need support for everything, whether it is errands, maintaining health, or even repairing around the house. Another opportunity can be translation services. Even though the year 2020 was not a good year for the translation service industry, it is projected to perform better in 2021. So the decline in translation service was due to pandemic and it will have a short-term effect, not in the long run. The growth of translation service is evident as the internet has effectively opened doors for entrepreneurs, for translators to provide services globally. And from the equipment front, you need a good computer or laptop and a high-speed internet connection. Whereas from the skill front, you need language proficiency. If you are a multilingual speaker, then offering translation services can be a successful endeavor. Another opportunity can be online teaching. Did you know online teaching started almost 3 decades back, but in 2020, it became widespread. It was undoubtedly a potential death blow to many medium and small schools. It brought opportunities to them to provide online teaching. As we have mentioned, online teaching is not new, but due to the pandemic, it has exploded worldwide and the demand for online teaching will surge to a new height this year in 2021. So if you are passionate about teaching, it could be the most profitable business opportunity. You can start it as a part-time thing, as your hobby, and you can actively get involved full-time once you grow. So the required skills include in-depth knowledge of the subject matter, such as math, history, biology, geography, management, finance, marketing. So if you are starting this business, your country, so being a specialized skills varying upon your experience and skills, you can charge good prices for that. Another incubator opportunity for early stage entrepreneurs can be the cloud kitchen, which we can also term as healthy meal delivery. Now, any professional parents with a couple of kids are overwhelmed with work management and work. Going to offices, spending time with kids, playing with them, and so on are daunting parents' tough. On top of that, they like to cook healthy and delicious food for themselves and their kids to stay healthy. But but their busy lifestyles leave no time to focus on all this together. So it could be an excellent opportunity to step in with the meal prep delivery business. You can prepare a balanced meal that is best of all, ready to eat. And if you are passionate about cooking and have acceptable practices of healthy food, this idea can fit you well. And another can be the video editing services. One of the top in-demand skills in 2021 is video editing. Both video marketing and YouTube are growing exponentially. So the opportunity for growth is literally limitless. And if you are proficient in Final Cut Pro, Adobe Premiere, then you are in good luck. Once you become a master in video editing, you can charge good amount, and as you grow, you can keep upgrading the charges. The required skills for the job is to be super fast and super good in video editing and creativity. And there are tons of people who are looking for video editing services, offering a lot of growth opportunities. You can create your accounts across Fiverr and other hiring sites to get work. Another opportunity can be the pet sitting business. Now, according to Fox News, pet adoption and fostering across USA has recorded a 700% increase during the last year in 2020. No doubt, excessive increase in number was due to stay-at-home orders that led people to seek pet companionship. Offering online pet sitting and care services can be an excellent opportunity for you. Consumers in large numbers, they are turning to online retailers to take care of their furry friends. And you can begin by providing pet products like homemade treats and toys, and gradually offer sitting services. So you can also watch their pet at their home when they are out. So it's a small business idea, but can run two income streams simultaneously. Then social media marketing. Are you passionate about social media and have got a knack for getting likes, favorites, recommendations, and all the hacks of social media? Then you have a secure and profitable career as a social media marketing professional. There are thousands of small and medium-sized businesses in USA, in India, in almost every country worldwide, struggling with their social media presence. So enterprises are looking to hire someone who can efficiently take care of their social media channels to promote their business. And you can consult companies by approaching them to manage their profiles across channels, promote their business products and services through content, respond to customers when they have any queries or more, and you can start this business from the comfort of your home and can perform while traveling from a resort anywhere you can bring your laptop. Another opportunity can be ebook writing for early stage entrepreneurs. They can open their business, they can hire people who will do this for them. If writing is your passion, and blog posts are not your style, you can choose to write for yourself. I'm not saying to write for free. You can earn while writing and publishing ebooks. All you need to have is excellent storytelling skills, lovely writing patterns, and a platform where you will publish your ebook, like Amazon, Fiverr, NaNoWriMo. These are the platforms that allow you to publish your book and earn as much money as possible. The success in this business lies behind your skills, interest in the subject, and usefulness of the story. So working with book publishing sites will save a lot of money. For example, you can get free ebook templates online. Designing work can be taken care of by a website, and your work will be just to write, publish, and market. Then affiliate marketing. If you have large fan followers across social media channels like Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and so on, you can get good bucks on behalf of promoting other people's business. You can earn by leaving a positive review and highlighting products and services on your blog, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, etc. And the income will be based on the higher your profile is. However, to start this business, you need to focus on personal branding. And you need to make your popularity across social channels, increasing fan following and actively communicating with your followers. If you are doing blog writing, you need to make sure that you write an interesting and useful piece that users find worth reading. Accounting or bookkeeping. With a little knowledge of accounting, ledger book maintenance, and some technical skills, you make good buckles out of bookkeeping business. Bookkeeping has made it possible to share your book with someone 100 miles away from you, and every successful business owner needs a reliable and smart bookkeeper. So if you are good with numbers and bookkeeping basics, then the idea could best fit for you. You can promote your services through Facebook ads promoting your business, through social channels, or you can explore online how to keep your online business strong. Then online personal assistant, or you can say virtual assistant. If you explore social media almost every week in your social feed, you will find someone asking if there is any virtual assistant to help them out. Now there are plenty of business entrepreneurs and business owners who need help with their day-to-day tasks like managing their calendar, travels, emails, and more. If you have high proficiency with both computer and internet, excellent communication skills, and more. With word of mouth marketing, you can quickly establish yourself in the market. If you have some advanced skills like being bilingual, a good understanding of software, or the ability to edit video can help you get hired. Online therapy, if you are a counselor, therapist, or psychologist, then starting online therapy or teletherapy services should be your goal. We are saying this because mental health treatment in the major cities around the world has shifted from face-to-face therapy sessions to exclusively teletherapy sessions. Besides, online therapy has recorded immense popularity during the lockdown as people needed support to keep themselves mentally fit. All you need is to team up with specialists such as psychologists, psychiatrists, mental health professionals, counselors, and social workers, and you are all set to assist people in need. Then contactless sanitizer dispenser. One thing that has changed forever post-COVID-19 is how people access supermarkets, restaurants, and small shops. People need to get the temperature check done and use hand sanitizers as a part of the new normal protocol. So this is where you can enter into a commercial sanitizer market by creating a sensor-based sanitizer dispenser. You can offer the dispenser with sanitizer and enable you to get hold of commercial clients regularly. Now, public health and hygiene are bound to remain the priority in the common interest, and this holds, especially with the rising number of infections during the second wave and businesses remain open. So this new business idea for sanitizer dispenser will also enable you to reach broader markets like factories, shopping malls, cinemas in the longer run. UVC disinfectants, transfer of persons from COVID-19 infected buildings to disinfect them constitutes a health risk, particularly in small rooms and restricted areas. So most drones cannot fly indoor and confined spaces, but you can use UVC light disinfection with special industrial drones to create the Aetos 120 UVC drone. So you can start with the UVC drone disinfection business. These drones are designed to fly indoor and enclosed spaces and provide UVC cleaning, reducing health risks. So potential sites include doctor's offices, emergency rooms, waiting rooms, grocery and convenience stores, companies, and areas between first responders and health workers. So UVC light sanitation technology in the healthcare sector is commonly used, but many UVC light systems are massive, post-prohibiting or uncommon. So many other businesses have used this life-saving technology by combining industrial drones with small but powerful UVC lights. Then drive-in movie theaters, again one of the most unusual type of small business idea that have recently achieved popularity in the coronavirus age is drive-in cinema. The regular film theaters are less safe as they let hundreds in small spaces to meet. So on the contrary, drive-in theaters allow people to have their private car shows and provide families with a way out. The initial trend before the lockdown was that people were choosing drive-in cinemas over the conventional ones. Although it is not clear whether these drive-in theaters stay open when many non-essential industries are closed, in a new era where holding the distances encouraged by the coronavirus epidemic, these companies may see a revival. And if you are looking to make a sound investment in the entertainment space, then starting a drive-in movie theater makes some sense. Another incubator opportunity for early stage entrepreneurs in today's scenario can be the game makers and sellers. Now the new coronavirus forces people to stay at home, rendering people to find more sense of purpose within the four walls. So since it is not advisable to move out alone and socialize, playing video games can make up for the void. This holds for the digital board games and puzzle makers as they drive virtual socialization to keep friends and families entertained. And families seek out quarantine fun, a testament to the same increasing demand for board games by 20%. Also, the market for children unable to attend school is growing for many small video game developers working on creative games. And these games are highly interactive to hold students' attention while providing them with the necessary education platform. So if you have creative small business startup ideas to leverage the opportunity, building a game can be a great advantage in the current scenario. Then SaaS and remote working tools fall right in the path of success in such times. With the temperamental changes that we are likely to witness, SaaS applications and remote working tools would facilitate the ongoing projects and pave the roadmap for future endeavors to greater extent. These applications would serve the founding stones for most business operations in the future and a haven for existing ones. So supporting the need of the hour while accentuating the current work culture to better productivity, this would help position or in the transition to a better stance for numerous brands across the globe. Pharma, life sciences, and lab pathology. Another major sector that came out to be a winner in this is the pharma, life science, and pathology. May it be a children, adult, or the elderly, in the wake of COVID-19 spread, most of the human population would wish to have enough health medication and facilities handy. And once a vaccine has developed, now every, you know, the shape of the current pharma industry has changed for good. Every single human being required a dose, and to provide for the demand at hand will be on the shoulders of our pharma industry. So these people would be providing for a noble cause, but to make a fortune for them is more than certain. And managed office spaces. Another sector that rise above the rest is the managed office spaces for corporates, startups, commercial real estates. So with the prevailing wave of remote working culture combined with businesses cutting costs aggressively, the need for cost-efficient, comfortable, managed office space is observed. With people unlikely to travel for work, these managed office spaces would provide a stable alternative to the need at startups, SMEs, and even corporate bodies are looking forward to cost cuts to balance things out, and these spaces provide the perfect solution to the same. So these are safer than conventional office hubs and come for a fraction of operational cost for the same. Then sustainable energy sales and service. Solar energy is going to be the future. So it is still not being able to catch the attention of large due to the excessive cost, but things are going to be different very soon. A lot of initiatives have been taken by the government and industry leaders to maximize the use of solar. As a result, you could have seen the solar energy cost has dramatically dropped and even continuously going down. So even the government authorities are providing tax and other benefits to those looking to start this business. You can consider grabbing this opportunity and your business will turn into a million-dollar company sometime very soon. Now, no doubt COVID-19 came as a nightmare for people ruining their lives, livelihoods. But as the saying goes, adversity opens up opportunities. So we need to think like that and explore the top potential business that will sustain no matter how tough the situation arises. The ideas given here are based on research, interviews, and support from the top market leaders, hoping that it might help you grow into your endeavor in 2021. And there is a plethora of small business startup ideas that you can think of. Start with writing a one-page business plan to incorporate one of the above ideas we have just discussed. The service, how you will price it, and our strategy to make it. You know, these ideas will help you ease the struggles of people while bringing a little money. So any business future will depend on how you can sell your new business to a position where you can be precisely and where you can grow. So the next decade is all about welcoming unique and modern innovation while ensuring users the niche they crave for. And a simple business like making and selling masks can have layers of creativity from the materials used to its design. The small business startup can flourish if you can gauge future opportunities better and stay prepared for unforeseen changes when the time comes. That's all from my side. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am. I request all the candidates, all the participants, if they have any query or if they want to ask anything, they can. Instead of writing in chats, I request you to please ask.
There is a question from Avinash that if you choose finance, like knowledge, then what are the career opportunities in future? So guys, if you are having very good skills and knowledge, you can go for bookkeeping business, you can go as a financial advisor, you can become an stock analyst, technical analyst, fundamental analyst, you can provide services in view of the investment alternatives people can go for. So these are the various sectors. If you choose finance, if you are having good skills in analyzing, you can advise people, you can help them in, you can help them in investment, in investing their businesses. And, to refine those skills, you can do some certification courses, like courses from NSE India. There are lots of good courses available in NCFM from NSE India. And you can go for those courses to refine your skills, to get updated with the policies and the norms. So you can go for that. You can become a certified financial planner. Yes, I have seen some student have written here as well. So you can go for that. Okay. Now one more question is there, that if we choose HR, then what are the opportunity, ma'am? So guys, if you are in an HR services or in human resources, the skills you are having, and it is a very beneficial opportunity for you. You can counsel people for their individual behavior, for their organizational behavior. You can start a counseling company in which you can counsel the corporates to resolve their personal issues. There are factories in which they are having good labor. They are having labor unions, contract labor. So you can provide your consultant services in managing those labor, in managing the disputes arises among the labor. So that's the benefit of having a human resource skills as well. So completely depends on what you people are studying in your classrooms, but what skills you are acquiring through theoretical studies. Yes, with the help of these studies, just try to convert that theoretical knowledge into the practical one. You are learning training and development, right? In HR, you can open a consultancy term in the same field, training and development, in which you can provide trainings to number of employees in the corporates, in big houses. If you are good in organizational behavior, you are learning organizational behavior, you are having a very good interest in that, you can open a consultancy company in that area, and you can provide your services in corporates. So there is a large number of opportunities out there even in this time.
Okay. Is there anyone else who wants to know or wants to ask anything? Okay. Thank you so much, ma'am. On behalf of TMU IIC, I extend my thanks to you for your precious time and knowledge sharing. Students feel enlightened definitely with your words. And of course, we learn a lot about the incubation opportunities. I would like to mention the few ones which I really like home care services, freelance copywriting, e-commerce, cybersecurity, and the most favorite, what I feel, healthy meal delivery, which is, I think, the most important requirement these days. Everybody wants to have a healthy meal, and which is not possible due to the hectic schedules. Everybody has to run for the offices and all. So this is going to be a wonderful idea for, I suppose, many of us. Then video editing services, online therapy. And of course, one more, which is very, I think, most required, is the manufacturing of sanitizer dispensers. This can be a wonderful, business for the early stage entrepreneurs. So thank you so much, ma'am. And hope we'll conduct some more sessions with you on these aspects. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for inviting me and for giving this opportunity. I am very thankful to the management team of Tirthankar Mahavir University, specifically the President and the team from Institution Innovation.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.